What's up, everybody? Welcome to Chapel Online. I know, unfortunately, this year we can't gather up at Anvil in the chapel together, but that won't stop us from worshiping our wonderful, great God. And so, why don't we sing? This first song you might know, you might not know, but it goes like this.
Wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. 1, 2, 3, 4, my lighthouse, my
suggestion. Anyways, now we got a testimony video coming for you all, so let's go to that.
Christianity was kind of like always a thing in our family. It was totally something that I didn't want to do. Just like the topic of a God and like an afterlife was just way over my head. And my aunt, she signed me up for summer camp at Anvil Island. One night in chapel. It was a evening chapel, and it was just like a time of response. I just remember all of a sudden I got like this feeling of just like joy and like shivers. And I remember just praying to God, like, I want to go back to high school as a Christian, following you. Looking back, my first year in grade 8, and I remember like just trying super hard to being super popular. making sure I looked good in the morning and making sure I hung out with the cool kids. At the end of the year, I just realized like every day I was just putting on like this fake mask. So it was so draining having to go to school every single day, having to be someone that you really weren't. And so, yeah, like I said, I just kind of asked God, I don't care anymore about what people kind of think of me. Like, if this means me losing, you know, a bunch of friends, like God, kind of have your way, do your thing. And now, you know, I'm lucky to have some of the coolest people in my life and kind of to do this, you know, this walk and this journey with me. I feel like one of the biggest gifts that God has given me is be able to use my musical talents, I guess, for the kingdom of God. You know, I get to do something that I love, and being able to do that, you know, for God, you know, leading people into a time of worship. And so I've been super thankful for how God has been using me up at Anvil, in my church, and in the communities around me.
My life is in the hands of the Maker of heaven. I lean not on my own understanding. My life is in the hands of the Maker of heaven. So I give it all to you, God, trusting that you'll make something beautiful out of me. So I give it all to you, God, trusting that you'll make something beautiful out of me. So I lean not on my own understanding. I lean not on my own understanding. Oh, no, I won't. So I give it all to you, God, trusting that you'll make something beautiful out of me. So I give it all to you, trusting that you'll make something beautiful out of me. So I will climb this mountain with my hands wide open. I will climb this mountain with my hands wide open. I will climb this mountain with my hands wide open. So I lean not on my own understanding. Oh, no, I won't. So I give it all. My life is in the hands of the Maker of heaven. So I give it all to you, God, trusting that you'll make something beautiful out of me. So I give it all to you, God, trusting that you'll make something beautiful out of me.
all had plans. Plans to see friends, to travel. And then the plan was to head up to Anvil, the perfect end to the summer. Well, we've all learned by now, plans change. Instead, the future seems unclear, unstable, and for some it seems not that safe at all. The path ahead appears uncertain and unchosen, but it is neither of those things to him. God the Father says, "Do not be afraid or discouraged, for the Lord will personally go ahead of you. He will be with you. He will neither fail you nor abandon you." His entire life, and then especially his death, was an expression of both his love for us and the power he has to go ahead of us for good. We may not be there, but he is no less loving, nor any less in control. He sees you still, he knows you still, and he has promised to walk with you in these days. Let's encourage each other to not be afraid, but have faith in his goodness and in his never-ending love for each one of us. A blessing on each one of you. Amen.